in space engineers, so yeah, we're going to be working on ships and continuing on the base. And I need to go get some energy here. Turn the lights on. You make it in yet, CJ?
Oh, I'm just parking up now.
Oh, okay. All right, cool.
No, you might lose me. Steam's not responding.
Uh-oh, okay.
Back in a short, I got 3 downloads that were pending.
Oh, okay. Made it in.
Yeah, see, it's giving me the option now to spawn again.
Really?
It might be because it's a, like I say, a co-op game.
Oh,
we'll find out after we get the cryos done and I log off in the cryo.
Does it give you the choice of medical bays?
Yep. Medroom 2, and the one on my ship.
Okay.
Which, I don't know, might have took damage.
When did you spawn into?
I chose my ship. I didn't like the looks of it.
Ah. There you are.
It was just the camera angle.
Yeah, I was had been looking at it out here. Everything looked fine on it from what I could see, so. Okay. Well, back to the medical bay.
Yep, gonna get that finished.
You want these other two cryos put in?
No, I'll go ahead and make them. I got to unlock the medical, then I'll move the medical, and then that'll unlock the cryo.
Oh, okay.
But I got to make the hydrogen. I'm going to move the hydrogen over to the other side, which is what unlocks the medical. So, it, you know, it's all a progressive.
Right.
Once I get caught up, it'll get easy.
Okay.
If you want, start digging out the roof. Like I say, it's going to be four blocks high, and the fourth block is going to be the roof, which is why I got those temp frames there.
So this is this a fourth? That's the fourth block right there, right? This top one?
No, that's the third one.
That's the third one. Okay, so we got to go
because the windows below are 3x3, so the windows will come up to here, and then we need one more for the roof.
Okay, all right.
Actually, I got refinery too. There's somebody too making steel plates.
Okay, all right.
Energy low.
So that back wall, I can go ahead and start stacking more blocks on that.
Yeah, behind the medical and cryos. That'll
yeah, where you had the stack going.
Yeah.
All right.
On the very back corner, those blocks will need to be welded up first while we can get to them before you place the
true. Yep.
You know, the frames.
Yep, absolutely.
Okay, when I get this piping done, then all we have to do is run to the corner to the cargo box and we can get our materials through that.
Okay, cool.
Okay, once you get the very corner one in, then you can just run the frames across the roof and whatnot, because we can get to them to weld. I'm going to put these two windows in.
Okay, all right. Yeah, I'm working on that back wall. I got that corner in on the one side.
meteor storm inbound.
Check the ammo on the guns.
Okay.
Energy low.
They're full. They only used like one round each.
Okay.
And I put the rest of the ammo that was made in the large cargo box. That way it'll pull from there if it needs it.
Yeah, I had it over in the weapons box.
Yeah. Finish filling in this wall?
I'm gonna leave a hole in the roof because I want to be able to take the parts from the med over into this room and use it. That way we don't have to make more medical kits.
Okay,
I'm trying
sure.
to find it as far as if I got it unlocked.
Oh, we do actually already have some medical kits already made, I think.
Oh, I found it. Yep, I got it and the cryo, so I can do both now.
Okay. There's three medical kits over here if you need them. I'm going to patch up this wall here then.
Yeah, the back wall can be entirely done. And I'm going to move the block for this because I want to rotate it. You can get all your materials right from this cargo box over here.
Oh, I didn't. Where is it?
I already finished the plumbing. I'll do the sorter afterwards. Because if I put the sorter in, we can only get oxygen through. But yeah, that corner,
oh, here
there,
it
just
is.
Go through it and pull
yeah,
it out
I
of
see
the inventory.
It. I kept trying to look for it, and I didn't see exactly where it was, so I found it. Let's... Get out of your way.
It wouldn't let me place it because your feet were in the area.
Oh. I was getting some more production going. I think I was anyway. Let's see here. Yeah, we got it going. All right. We're going to need another entrance into that side over there, aren't we?
Yeah, but that'll come off the corridor out there.
Right, right.
You know, this will be the medical room. We can see in that, you know, the yeah. utility room.
Well, I was going to start drilling that
but
out.
The utility doesn't have to be airtight, so we just right. make a walkway, whereas this room should be airtight.
Yeah, I was just going to start drilling this out over there.
No, the O2 generator is already full.
Oh, are they? I believe we're out of iron. Oh, no, that's just... Oh.
Yep, we are.
Well, I guess I can go, I'll go mine some iron. We're definitely going to need that. DJ, you say, if I remember correctly, you said you're up in Minnesota, right?
Yep.
Yep. You'll laugh. My t-shirt that I have on tonight is from one of my buddies up there. It says the Elks Youth Camp from 2010. They run a youth camp up there and gave me one of their shirts. Okay, first load's coming back on my way back. Are you still there, CJ?
Yep, I did a Peter Paul routine.
Okay.
Oh, connection problem. Spike.
Oh, I just got that too. Had that the other day, but you were still in. You didn't seem to drop.
Okay, if you queue up something, go ahead and use the assembler, regular assembler. And when I queue up something, I'll use the assembler too.
Okay. I'm heading for more ore. There should be stuff, the interior plates and stuff should be producing
now.
Yeah,
I've already got everything done. I'm working on the windows now.
Okay. right, on my way back with another load. Probably should get a couple of more loads, then that should do us for a little while, right?
Yeah, all depends on what we build.
Yeah.
Or, you know, make. We're going to go through it fast or slow.
Yeah, so, yeah, I'll get a couple more loads after this one. Get a little bit of a stockpile on it. We went quite a ways on that last bit, so. All right, there's another load in. Off we go. All right, I'll get this load over there and one more, and then that should do us for iron for a little while. right. It's yanking it through about as fast as I can bring it back, it looks like.
Yeah, it's yanking it to the refineries because they have the capacity to pull it all.
Yeah. I'll get one more load, and then that should do us for quite a while. I hope, anyway. Hey, Dustin, you made it on. How you doing?
You make it in-game, or is he chatting?
He's just chatting, yeah. I got Wartar. CJ is in-game with me, Dustin. I get this load of iron and I'm head back to the base. I'm doing good. Doing good. We're making some progress on the base. Once I get this load, I'll show you how it's looking. Dustin says, "What's up?" Well, yeah, I know. That's going to be great as soon as you get that card. We've got a surprise for you. We're going to show you what we got going. Yeah, I got some ideas for you. We'll chat offline on that. I think there's some things that we can do with that. But I think looking at the stats on your computer, you get that graphics card in there, then we should be able to get you up and running. We'll need to turn down. We'll probably have to turn down some of the settings within Space Engineers. But yeah, once we get that going. You should be good. Oh, nice. You got tomorrow off, don't you? Yeah, I have it off tomorrow too, but I've got errands to do. I get to go put a new windshield in my truck tomorrow. Wow. Well, that's one thing. I always get the weekends off. You guys got a lot of rain here the last couple of days, didn't you? We are. DJ's back at the base, and I'm on my way back with a load of ore. Yeah, I was seeing on the Weather Channel how much rain you guys are getting down in there. Oh no. That's not going to be good. Yeah, that's the problem down south like that. You get those big rainstorms. Although, from what it looked like you might get some breaks in the storms. Yeah. Rest of this unloaded. Where to go? There we go. Got all of that. Yeah, that's usually what happens at those golf tournaments. All right, turn that off. Turn that off and do that. Okay. All right. Well, let me cruise over here. Is he? There he is.
Check the rough.
There, that's what CJ's working on. He's working on the new welder. To work on the base. So there he is there. Well, you would be in game, so I don't know if I'd be able to see you on the camera, but you would be in game. So here's what we've been working on. We made cryo chambers. So we got an airtight room. And it's sealed in. So I should be able to do this. Yeah, see, I could take my helmet off or my face mask and be able to breathe in here because it's airtight. And we're making cryo chamber. We've got four cryo chambers, so when you're in game and then we get out, you can go into the cryo chamber and then save, and you shouldn't lose any of your stuff here in this game. So yeah, so we're getting it all done and ready to go. Basically, hypersleep for travel.
Did you close the outer door before you opened the inner door?
I did.
Okay. Yeah, because that's the whole point of the two doors, keep the air in.
Exactly. So I'm heading back out now. All right. This looked pretty good. It is. It's real detailed. It's really into the physics of it too. So you've got to pretty much be within bounds of the physics. Otherwise, you're going to have unexpected results. And I'm going to try to finish that walkway around into that other room. Interior plating I needed. Let's see. Let's get some of these going. Yeah, once you get your machine up and running, the first thing I would do, you know, and then fiddle with your adjustments in Space Engineers, and then I would go through the very first kind of that introductory scenario. I haven't played PUBG. Again, it's one of those games. It's just like Fortnite. I haven't gotten into the online transaction loot box games. Okay. Yeah, I think it is. I think Fortnite is more cartoonish, but I mean, that's okay. Oh, I know. There's a lot of people that have a lot of fun with it. More of these going. Okay, construction components and I do watch football. I'm a Lions fan. And I like watching college football. That's great.
Did you just grab some computers?
I don't think so. I just grabbed construction components. I saw some there. There should be, I don't know if they're in the assembler or in the large storage bin.
Well, I made some, and I used the connector over on the other side to put them back in the large cargo.
Yeah.
And when I dropped them in, they went out of my inventory, but did not appear in the large cargo.
Well, let me see something, because I saw them there just last time I was in there. Yeah, there's 9 and 37 here at the bottom.
See, I'm not seeing it.
All right, here, let me grab them. And
do you see the 125 plates in the assembler?
I see 215, and I see 60 computer in the first assembler. Okay, let me put these back in the large cargo and see if you see them. All right, I just put 46 back in there.
Yeah, see, it's not changing. Or at least for me, it's not changing.
I'll be darned. Let me go put them in the small cargo.
What I'm going to do is log out in the cryo.
Okay.
Go have me a cigarette because we can't smoke in the house no more.
Oh.
Roommate's wife just had surgery and there's no longer any smoking inside. So we have to go outside in this lovely weather.
Yeah, it's always lovely up in Minnesota. I hear you. That's why I dip. I don't smoke, so I dip.
Yeah, well, it was supposed to have been in like 60 today, but it missed it by about 20 degrees.
Is that all? All right. I'll see you when you get back in.
Maybe by relogging fixes the bug.
Okay.
Because I redid the piping. If you look over in the corner, there's actually now a conveyor junction below that other projector that's on the side. So when I need materials, I just go through that instead of, you know, flying all the way inside.
Oh, yeah.
It's right there. Now, the roof still has a hole. So there's a projector on the roof that's got the welder now.
Okay, yeah.
Which only needs 40 battery, whatever's, 20 each, and then the other two batteries are done. I did one, so I've already unlocked.
Is all the framing in?
Well, it's all done except for the back two batteries and then adding the ion engines.
Okay.
And then it'll be ready to go. And then cut off the lower leg part. And
okay,
add
I was going to say I could start welding on some of this stuff here if the framing's all in.
Yeah, I would. If you got some steel, I'd queue up. Well, you need the grids for those too, so I'd queue. I think you've got like 300 or 400 grids, so I'd queue up some 2,000 or 3,000 steel plates so you can start getting that hangar done.
Okay, yep.
Now, the one on the roof is called Projector 2 Roof.
Yeah,
the
okay.
Control pad is Pro 2 on the roof, you know,
okay.
Kind of thing. So they're all, you know, you go into the control panel on the back side of the column near the projector, and there's the keypad, and it's right next to the projector that it's associated with, which there's different names now.
Okay.
Which they'll be the same color because they're both beyond the rotor. But then that gives us a means of we can build up on the roof, which is where I got the welder.
Yep.
We're over on the side, which is where I'm going to build my miner so I can help you with getting ore.
Okay. All right. Okay. Yeah, that's good. I'll start getting that stuff queued up. And yeah, we'll go enjoy. Try not to freeze to death out there.
Say, queue that stuff up under assembler, the regular assembler.
Let me see.
And then let's go with 2 ions, 6 directions, that's 12. If we go 3 ions, oh, we've already got the over in those 3 boxes that are not connected.
Right.
One of them's got the thruster thing.
Right. There
it's
should
got the
be
reactor component, but it also has the thruster.
I think
component.
So. Yeah.
Yeah. Pull that out of there, like 100 or 200,
okay,
and put them in the large construction.
All right, I got some stuff queued up there. Let me move those.
And if you do the 2 batteries, just plop on 2 or 3 ion engines in all 6 directions.
Okay. That's why you love the South, huh, Dustin? Well, I couldn't deal with the humidity down there. I am much happier with it being cold, to be honest with you. I know it sounds crazy. See, I live but not the, you know, that's why I didn't move all the way back to Western Washington. I picked here in Wyoming because of the scenery and the weather. It's much drier here, so you're still getting sunny weather, and to be honest with you, when it is 55 and 60 out, it still feels pretty good. Okay, I need power cells. Looks like everything else is there. Power cells, okay. You know, it is, especially when you get over to the mountains. I'm out on the plains where I'm at. first spell. See. That's what that, yeah, up above, that's what that's all about, is that ship up above. So that's going to be a mining ship they're looking for. Power cells. Yeah, while those are, while I'm waiting for those to get done, I'll show you. So this ship here is a mining ship.
Energy low.
And what this ship is going to be, this is a construction ship. So these are arc welders that are on here. And so there's two of them. So you can load up the cargo bays with all your materials, like for this here. And then you can, instead of the little bit of inventory that I can carry back and forth, you can load this up and then really get quite a bit done. So this is kind of a hangar area where we can park the ships. And then the inside of the base is down and in here. So this is the airtight room. This is our medical room and control room. And then this is where we did have the medical room. So this is where we've got our remote control, and then we've got a gravity generator here. So I could actually sit down and just walk around like you see here. So I'm not sure what all we're going to put over here, but this will be like a separate room. This is bulletproof glass that you could look through and look into the medical control room. And then this is just going to be another room. And right now, this room over here is really our production and power room. So I've got, we've got the large cargo bay where everything gets put in there. It's all hooked in with conveyors. You can see that. That's a refinery with an assembler on it. This is a refinery with an assembler on it. So both of those can pull all the materials they need from the large cargo bay. So these red dots, let's see if I can get up here and show you them. So you see these red dots like that there? That's enemy ships, pirates. And they will attack you if they get close enough. If they get close enough and discover you, they'll send gunships. So far, I've only had the gunships come once in this playthrough. Of course, we haven't really gone after them to speak of either. So we've always tried, we've been trying to avoid them. At some point, we're going to get strong enough that then we can go out and maybe raid some of the freighter ships and stuff like that. Let's let's see. That those power cells should be about done. Let's see. Let's take 40 of them. Should be able to finish off those two batteries. Yeah. Feels that's can be kind of interesting. Back in, CJ?
Yeah, and I came back in the cryo.
Oh, very good. Very good. All right. Well, have fun with baby duty, Dustin. I'm glad you stopped in. It's always good. So, yeah, you better get a little bit of sleep anyway. Otherwise, you're going to be pretty pretty droopy-eyed in the morning, I'm sure. So, have a good evening, Dustin. Talk to you later. Okay, got the two batteries done. I didn't get a chance to do the thrusters yet, so we can go ahead and lay those in. I was kind of showing the dust around the base a little bit.
Yeah, that's what I just put on my hot bar.
All right. I moved all of the thruster components and stuff over into the large chamber, and there should be computers in there. There are. So why don't you see if you can see them now?
Yep, can see it all.
All right. That might be, you know, some of that where you see it lose connections every once in a while. I wonder if that might be what causes it.
Needs about 1,000 construction.
Yeah, I got probably need some more, much more of that steel plating. So I also got the grids going.
Well, they're not going because you're out.
Oh, all right.
Then pulling something.
All right. I mean, I'll get some more going. What are we missing? Are we out of cobalt? Ah.
Like iron. Well, no, we have 75 iron, so it's not
right.
Bad.
We should be good. I think it's the cobalt.
Yep, I'm not seeing any.
All right. Well, how about I go make a run for cobalt?
Well, you got 1,300 grids. How much do you need for each block?
50.
So 500 for 10.
It's going to need a lot of grids.
Oh, yeah, 3,000 or 4,000.
Yep.
Yeah, definitely a cobalt run.
All right, I'll go get that now. Well, son of a gun. For some reason, I lost my grouping on... Alright. Let's see. Okay, now let's write drills. And my lights. Oh, we got a mining carriage that's getting awful close.
The antenna off on the miner?
It is. I'm gonna go ahead and park it. Just
okay, you're starting to drift away now.
I'll hope long as he didn't pick up anything, we don't see anything else pop up, then we should be okay. That's not the best place to be. Kind of need you to stay out of the way. Can't sit on my mouse hand. Yeah, Cobalt was a little bit farther away. right, one load of cobalt. Just getting ready to head on back. You still there at the base, CJ?
Yeah, hooking up the welder.
Okay. you give your dog her shot?
Meteor storm inbound.
Okay, I gotta empty the inventory first. right. Lights off, locked. Thrusters off. Battery on recharge. Okay, I see a construction ship sitting here.
Yep, just setting up the quick bar.
All right. Sail. Military mine layer, right?
What welder? I don't see no welder.
What's that?
I don't see no welder.
What do you mean you don't see no welder? Just turn the spotlights on.
Okay, now that'll get it power, which is what, you know, all it needs. But that connector's not connected to nothing.
That's, oh, okay.
That's what I use for a parking spot.
Okay.
So it's over to the side, out of the way, so you can go in and out.
Yeah.
But to recharge the batteries, you know, or to park it,
yep,
it just goes right on there.
Right on there.
I had to change the connector on the back. I just ran a large elbow. So
oh,
the
okay.
connector was facing downward. Because
okay.
this comes with the connector facing to the back, and we don't have a rear one.
Right. So that hot bar, it's got the same setup, basically, for...
Well, let me hit the thing. Okay, if you want to hop in there and see if you see the hot bar.
Okay. I do. I see the welders, one and two.
Okay.
The lock, the recharge.
I didn't use a sensor and set all that up as a safety feature, but when you're welding and you're going from A to B, or before you jump out, you make sure that second one says off.
Okay.
Because otherwise, if you get too close to the welders, you're dead.
Right.
Kind of thing. That's why the welder is one to do the action.
Okay.
And then the second is the on and off. And then mostly, you know, the next one is the connector, because that's pretty much
right.
what we'll be doing is hooking mm-hmm. up to drag the materials in. The next one's the battery, which I switched. You hit the battery again, it'll switch to auto. So that's one click. Now you see the engines. They're the same way I have mine set up, where the first one is all of them.
What's that red dot that's, it's starting to get a little farther away. What is that? Oh, it's a private sale. Probably okay. Pretty close, actually. All right.
Yeah, but it's on the other side of the rock.
Yeah.
And all the antennas are off, so
yep.
that's not an issue.
I just get nervous when they get that close, is all. I've had my run-ins
yeah, but
with
if you
them.
Look at the engines, the first one turns all the ions on.
Okay.
The second one, which requires you to use the first, cuts the drift off, which means if you're going somewhere to weld in this thing,
oh, okay.
Or you take the welders off and put grinders on, because you can interchange them.
Right.
If you're going somewhere, you turn the drift off so it gets, you know, goes further.
Right.
That kind of thing. And then it's the on and off of the lights. Second bar is where the antenna is, and I have something else there. Oh, the projector.
Oh, okay. So that's...
Get this out, I'll set the projector up, so if it does any damage, you just turn the projector on. It creates an image, and you just go around and weld.
Okay. All right, let me hop out.
But if you look here, I could have put the connector here on the bottom, in the front, underneath the cab.
Right.
But you want to keep the front part of the ship like a wedge.
Sure.
You don't want anything like a connector hanging down while you're trying to get into a tight spot.
Right. You want to be able to get into those spots, some, you know, and that gives you that ability. Yep.
And the other thing is, when dealing with a welder, this does not have oxygen, because the oxygen generator involves small grid.
Oh, okay.
Now, I could have reworked it, but it would have made it longer. But this is basically connector boxes, junction boxes is what it is.
Sure.
But the small ports are facing up and down. So on the plane that the cargo is and the cab and the welders, it's all large connectors.
Oh, okay.
Okay, see on top here, these are little ones?
Right.
If you look on the back side of that same block, see how it's a large?
It's a large, yep.
All right, this from the front to the back at that level, it's all large connectors.
Okay.
Which all materials will pass through. Now, if you had small grid, the little connectors somewhere along the piping, which I have on my ship, mm-hmm. I have to figure out where I messed up. But the one I used for scouting and that.
Right.
Somewhere along the way, I have small grid connectors, which do not let small pipes, steel plates, and some other things through. They just won't pass.
Sure.
Which you don't want on a welding ship.
Right, because you got to have everything passing through.
Whatever you put in the cargo box to, you know, apply.
Yep, absolutely. All right, well, is there anything else you have to wrap up on here? I'm going to have to call it a night here pretty quick.
Welder's done. That basically put a roof on this thing.
All right.
And then you can try it out with, you should have enough plates and...
Yeah.
Grids that you can fire it up and
yep.
try her out.
All right. Well, that'll be for tomorrow, I guess. Start doing that. And then I guess we can probably work on expanding that base back some more. Or there's plenty of room through back through the asteroid to maybe streamline that production area where the refineries are and stuff like that. So all right,
there you go. So, yeah, the next project is actually get this hangar done.
Yep, yep.
So that the ships inside don't take any damage while the guns are shooting whoever.
Right. Yep, exactly. And...
Now, back here, if you look at this second projector, I put hardened blocks underneath it. So if they do get a lucky shot and they destroy the rotor, the inside is protected by hardened blocks.
Okay. All right. Yep. Yeah, anything that could possibly be exposed, that's what I've always tried to do, is put the hardened, the heavy armor.
It was a half block.
Yeah.
Shouldn't have been there. Probably was a miscue from when I did it.
Okay.
Half block below.
The only place that I might have used light armor would be right there in these very back blocks that are going back into the...
Yeah, well, that's where rock is, you know.
Yeah.
No biggie. Plus, it's under a ledge.
Yeah.
But this one here, using the roof, you can do small and large ships.
Not absolutely.
Really,
yep.
Not really big ones, but you can do it here on the back side, and while the two guns are
yep.
up in the front, watching your back, so to speak.
Yep. Perfect. All right.
That's why I tucked this one in over here. Only difference is this one has a connector right at the base. So when I need materials to weld, I just go right there. I don't have to go
all the way inside. Oh, okay, right, right. Yep.
So
Yep, you can just...
From there, I can do my welding ship, one of them.
Yep.
Get some more ore in here, so... Probably going to end up using your miner.
Yeah. Well, that's...
Well, let me show you.
Where you at?
Going to basically use your miner to go in here and go under the hangar.
Okay.
So the floor of the hangar is actually going to be the roof, but it, you know, it's still protected. We don't have to weld nothing.
Right.
And that's where I'm going to park that ship.
Oh, okay.
Underneath. After I get done with it for now. And then whenever we want to take it out, we can just back it up straight
right.
And then just take off.
Yep. That makes sense.
That way there's no more plates are needed because the hangar itself is the roof.
Yep.
And for anything to come in here, it's got to get by those two guns.
Right. It's got to get by the guns. We'll hollow it out, and then you'll have the sides. The only place that will have any kind of exposure would just be from the front.
Well, a miner is a quick way to hollow it out.
Yeah, exactly. Yep.
Go in the middle and then, you know, go according. And that ship is not that big, so that miner actually would bore a hole out big enough for the ship except for maybe that assembler sticking up.
Right.
That's on the back end.
But
I needed those to unlock the refineries and whatnot.
Sure.
So I may take those off. Slap a regular assembler on it.
Yep. Okay, well, I'm starting to run out a lot of steam, and I've got to get up early. I got to go spend money that I don't want to tomorrow. Truck needs tags and a new windshield, so the joys of living up north.
I know. I got to put the battery charger on mine, get it charged up. Okay, which one do you want?
I'm on my way over. Let's see.
Hang on, let me close the inner door.
Okay. Closed?
Okay.
Heck, I'll take the, here, let me do this first. I'll take the end one right here, how about that? And
we'll leave one next to you for Justin.
Yep, alright, let me hop in there. Let's see, assuming it's just F. No. How do you get into the cryo chambers?
You got to look at it until the center highlights in yellow.
Oh,
then
oh.
Click out.
All right. So like that, then I should... There we go. All right. All right.
It has air, oxygen, so it'll automatically top off. It's like you hit the keypad over there.
Yep.
You know, to top them all off. Just by getting in the cryo, you top them off now.
Okay. All right.
Because
very good.
It's all hooked up. The only thing is, when you get out of the cryo, most of the time, it will turn your jetpack off.
Oh, okay. All right.
So, you know, it's just a matter of turning the jetpack back on.
Yep.
Which is no big deal.
Okay, well, I'm going to, let's see, hang on, I'm going to, let me finish up the stream here. And that's going to do it for this video, and Commander Kingfish is out of here. And we'll see you all in the next stream or video.